Recently, I noticed a debate in the archery community over whether heavier arrows could improve penetration depth. The people interested were primarily bow hunters asking if heavier arrows could get them cleaner kills. This topic has a lot of misinformation going around about it, and it isn't much better on physics forums. I noticed a basic trend. The light arrows camp would often claim that light arrows had more energy because they were faster. They also claimed that energy was all that mattered. Thus, they concluded that light arrows were better, or at the very least, as good as heavy ones. On the other hand, the heavy arrows camp claimed that momentum was what really mattered. They also pointed to experimental evidence for heavy arrows penetrating deeper. Looking into this from a historical perspective, this debate is actually quite old. There are arguably heavy arrow cultures and light arrow cultures. The heavy arrow cultures include the English with their longbowmen, the Japanese, and the Manchu. Even against armored opponents, their bows had a fearsome reputation. On the other side of the spectrum, the Saracens and the Turks used lighter arrows. These archers were renowned for their range, the speed of their arrows, and the sheer volume of fire they put out. So enough of this, let's talk about bow physics and arrow penetration. Let's start by examining bow operation. First, the bow stores a certain amount of energy in the draw. Looking at the force to draw distance plot of a simple bow, the force increases linearly with draw distance. The total energy stored during the draw is given by the area underneath a curve. On a side note, a considerable amount of work has been done to make the force curves on modern bows non-linear. This is to maximize the stored energy for a given draw weight. After we store the energy in the bow, we transfer that energy to the arrow. This is done by pulling the ends of the bowstring apart to move the mill forward. The ratio of arrow movement to bow tip movement spikes at release, resulting in most of the energy being transferred to the arrow. In other words, this is a very efficient transfer of energy. So what's the takeaway from this? Well, except in extreme cases, the energy of the arrows is mainly determined by the bow. Sure, energy transfer is more efficient for heavy arrows, but it doesn't change massively. This means that our model should give heavy arrows and light arrows the same starting energy. Great, now that's out of the way, let's talk about penetration depth. Let's see what models might favor large mass per cross-sectional area. I think I'll do something close to Newton's approximation. I'll model the target as a bunch of weights on springs and hit it with an arrow. When the arrow hits a weight, it will knock it out of the way in an elastic collision. It will then hit another weight, and the process will repeat itself many times. This can be simplified further by ignoring the side components and doing a series of 1D elastic collisions. Simulating two arrows of equal energy, we find that the lighter one slows much more quickly than the heavy one. A quick plot of velocity and force shows that this is just a derivation of drag, but it shows that mass matters in at least one regime. Of course, if you're willing to accept this without any evidence, I have a bridge to sell you. You're going to need experimental evidence, which most people aren't set up to do. Thankfully, in the modern age of the internet, anyone can look at a slow motion video and plot the projectile position frame by frame. It's actually amazing how much information you can extract from this method. Using this technique to analyze bullets in ballistic gel, I found that the force was actually linear with velocity. This suggests that the gel is behaving as a viscous fluid. A little calculus and we find that momentum linearly decreases with distance. Thus, the starting momentum determines the maximum penetration. Does this work for arrows? Yeah, more or less. There's a little weirdness at the end, but the rest works out fine. So, in conclusion, both bullets and arrows are in the viscous drag regime, where momentum determines penetration depth. When fired from the same bow, heavier arrows get more penetration, provided cross-sectional area remains the same. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe.